everyone, my name is Anna and welcome to Cactus Caffeine. In this channel, I share my passion of growing desert plants in a desert environment over a cup of coffee. Today, I will be featuring the different types of aloes that I have. There are over 500 known species of aloes and a lot more new hybrids are coming out. I love aloes. They are my second most favorite desert type plant, next to cactus, of course. They come in different sizes, forms, and the color variety is spectacular. They are also very hardy plants. If you are one of those who sometimes neglects your plants, like I do, aloes are very well suited for you. Enough of my introductions and let's get a closer look at each of these aloes. I will be presenting my aloe collection according to their color. So let me start off with this aloe that gives out a bluish tint of color on it. So this aloe is called the Blue Elf Aloe. So how appropriate. So as you can see, the leaves has a bluish green color on it. It also has that white powdery substance that coats the leaves, so it protects it from extreme sun exposure. So refrain from touching the leaves because the powder comes off easily and they do not grow back. This Blue Elf Aloe produces a long inflorescence of orange flowers, very pretty, usually in spring. So they start flowering when it receives more sun exposure. And likewise, this Blue Elf Aloe, actually, if you stress it under sunlight and cold temperature, it can actually change its color to somewhat like this. So this is also a Blue Elf Aloe, but in comparison, you can see this is a little bit pinkish in color. Light plus cold temperature will stress this aloe and make it change its color to something like this with pinkish edges or pink tips on it. Now these are my aloes that are green in color, but they have variegation on them or they have some prints on their leaves. So let me start off with this one. This is an aloe snowstorm. So this one is more of green and white in color during the summer, but since it is winter right now, it has the stress color on the tips of its leaves. This is growing in my garage under the grow light, although I'd rather have it that green and white color rather than the stress color, because when this one is stressed, it actually turns into more of a chocolate brown in color like this one on the right. So I prefer it to be green and white. So this is aloe snowstorm. And then another aloe that is oftentimes confused with this one is this aloe blizzard. So I got questions, how is aloe blizzard different from an aloe snowstorm? So here they are. So an aloe blizzard, this one on the right, has more white markings on its leaves rather than green. So even under the leaves, see, very pretty, it's more white than green, while this aloe snowstorm has more of like dots of white marks on the leaves, more of like a snow on top of the leaves. So aloe snowstorm and aloe blizzard. So this aloe blizzard right now is actually in flower. So this is how the flower of this aloe blizzard looks like. So this one is an aloe lizard lips. This one is also currently in flower, and in terms of flowering, based on my experience, I find that they flower once you give them enough sunlight. So as soon as they start receiving enough sunlight, then they start shooting out this long inflorescence of flowers. So both of these, the aloe lizard lips and the aloe snowstorm, they are growing under my grow light in the garage. Hence, that probably explains why they are both in flower right now. These two aloes right here are actually the same, although this one has a more yellow variegation on it compared to this one on the right. So for these type of aloes, I give them filtered sun because I find that the more variegation that they have, the more protection from the sun that they need. Also, variegated ones, they grow slower than the pure green version of this aloe. This is another one of my green aloes with white markings on its leaves. It came with no name label. Looking it up online, my guess is it is an aloe quicksilver, also sometimes called an aloe white stag. I could be wrong, so if you know the name of this aloe, please let me know in the comment section down this video. But I love how this aloe is almost all white. Kinda like my aloe blizzard, but this one has whiter leaves. This one is a Goni aloe variegata, so it is known by many different names, but this aloe is very distinct looking. So I find this aloe more tender or more delicate compared to the other types of aloe. So I give this a filtered sun in the morning or bright shade because the leaves will easily burn if you expose it to direct sun. Also, this is not very frost hardy, so try to keep it at a temperature, minimum temperature of, for me, it goes down to 45 degrees Fahrenheit. It's still doing okay, but try to prevent this from freezing temperatures. And now let us move on to my red and pink aloes. So right now they are showing the red or pink with a purple tinge of color on them because of the cold temperature and the proper amount of sunlight or light that they are receiving right now. But if you look at these same aloes in the summer, they would be mostly green and pink in color. This one is Aloe Doni. And then this one right here, I believe is a Castiglione hybrid. Very pretty. Look at those teeth, the red teeth on them. They look mean, but they are very, very pretty. And here's another one right here. This is also the same type of aloe, the Aloe Castiglione hybrid. This is an aloe firecracker, and take a look at that bright pink color in it. This one is definitely on fire. So very, very beautiful. And then right next to it is an equally beautiful aloe oik. So this one in the summer, it's more green and pink in color, but with enough exposure to light, it turns this very bright pink and purplish color on the leaves. So in terms of soil, so anything that I can see on the market that's made for cactus and succulents, that's what I use, although I try not to get those with a lot of peat moss in it because peat moss tends to dry out very fast. And I find that these aloes actually prefer a little bit more water or a little bit more moisture compared to cactus. So as long as your soil is very well draining, they will appreciate it. These two aloes right here, they're actually the same. Now, I am not sure if this is Delta Dawn or Delta Lights, one of those, because it did not have any name when I bought it. So in the summer, this is also more green, white, and pink, like the color that you see there at the center. But when stressed with enough light and cooler temperatures, it becomes this bright pink and purplish color. These are both Kelly Griffin hybrid aloes. So Kelly Griffin is a famous breeder of succulents here in the US. So both of these are Christmas aloes because in warmer months, they have that red and green Christmas colors on them. When these are young, it is actually hard to tell them apart because they look very similar. But if you look at the Christmas sleigh up close, its teeth are more pronounced, or they're bigger on the edges. Compared to a Christmas carol, the teeth are smaller, thus creating that outline on the edges of the leaves. Now, these two aloes have been growing in my garage under a grow light. So this is how it looks when it is stressed. It's more purplish, but in the summer, the color of these is actually more green or yellow green. Now, one interesting fact about this aloe is that you can also stress it by just sunlight. So it doesn't need cold temperature for it to get this stress color. In fact, during the summer, I had these two pots growing in different areas of my garden. I had one growing under filtered sunlight, and I had one growing in full sunlight. So the one that was growing in full sunlight was more stressed, and it had that purple color, while the other one had more of that green color on it. Now, this part right here, I actually accidentally knocked down this pot and broke the top part of that leaf. But interestingly enough, I discovered that when they get stressed, it's actually only the top layer of the aloe or the leaf that changes color, not the entire leaf. Very interesting discovery. Let us now move on to the next color grouping. So these are my green aloes. This one is Aloe Crosby's Prolific, and very true to its name, it is very prolific indeed. So I've taken out a lot of pops from this mother plant. I've given away a lot, and I have some pops growing in this pot right here. Another one right here, and I'm sure I have a couple of more pots in my backyard out of this mother plant. So this Aloe Crosby's Prolific, it produces a very beautiful white flower from a very long inflorescence. And this one is not frost hardy, and I found that out the hard way 2 years ago. I exposed this to freezing temperature, and what happened was the tips had freeze burns and they all broke off. So as you can see, the leaves at the bottom, they don't have tips because the tips suffered from freeze burns. So this one can take a little bit more sun, but not too much because you can also burn them. But compared to the other type of aloes, this one can take a little bit more sun, except try not to expose it to very cold temperature. So right now I have this growing inside my greenhouse, where I keep the temperature to a minimum of 40 degrees Fahrenheit, and it is holding up pretty well. In my experience, aloes will grow between the temperatures of 50 degrees Fahrenheit up to 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Extreme temperatures will make them go dormant. Most of them have high heat tolerance and can withstand temperatures over 100 degrees Fahrenheit as long as you provide them some protection from direct sunlight. My aloes grow under a shade cloth during the hottest part of our summer here in Las Vegas. So this one grows bigger. So when it was given to me, it was small, but when I planted it in a big pot, it actually grew very, very fast. So in terms of watering my aloes, I water them heavily, and then I let the soil go dry in between waterings, but I don't let them go dry very long because I find that aloes want a little more water compared to cactus. And you can usually tell if your aloes need water based on the leaves, because the leaves will start to thin out, and that is your sign that they actually need water. But if the leaves are plump, then do not water them. They will be very fine because they can store a lot of water in their leaves and in their stems. This is an Arist aloe aristata, or also known as the lace aloe. This plant used to be classified under aloes, but recent studies indicate that it has some characteristics that are distinct from aloes. It has therefore been moved to its own genus, Arist aloe. But for the sake of this video, we will still include this in my aloe collection. This is a compact aloe that has tiny white bumps on its green leaves. However, this is not very hardy to extreme temperatures. Too hot or too cold, it easily gets stressed and changes the color of its leaves to purple-brown. Prolonged stress will make it close its rosette to protect itself. Aloes are not heavy feeders, but they will definitely benefit from receiving fertilizer during their growing season. I use any commercially available fertilizer formulated for cactus and succulents. I fertilize once a month during their growing season. I have a few aloes here with no ID, like this green one right here. I don't know the name of that one, as well as this one. So it grows very tall, but I don't know the name of that, as well as this pretty one right here with like white dust on the leaves. And then this one is, I believe it's an aloe. Somebody told me this is an aloe, although I still don't know the exact ID of this one as well. So if any of you can help me out, please write the names of these aloes in the comment section down below this video. This one is a little bit different because this is actually a cross between a gasteria and an aloe. So knowing that one of the parents is a gasteria, you would want to give this a little bit more protection from the sun. So ideally, bright shade or filtered morning sun is best for this aloe. Of course, an aloe collection is not complete without an aloe vera. I have this aloe not because I like the way it looks, but because I use this for its medicinal benefits. Whenever I get burns from cooking or insect bites, I rub the gel of these aloe on my skin. That is why this plant looks beaten up. Some of the tips are missing because I have been using this aloe vera. This concludes my video of my growing aloe collection. Before I end, I would like to know more from you guys. Do you grow aloes? And if you do, what is your favorite aloe in your collection? Give me a thumbs up and write your answer in the comment section below this video. I will talk to you again next time. Bye and cheers!